I thought I could sort out the financial problem myself. I genuinely did think, you know, I can sort this out somehow. I can turn this around. I think when the band decided to split, yeah, there was two things going on in my head. You should be sitting on a few quid and you should be quite comfortable and going, okay, the band's over, but, you know, we've done well, we've worked hard, we've earned money. But I didn't have any money, you know? So I knew it was going to be a kind of an uphill battle. It was quite a scary week. I felt very weird for about 2 to 3 weeks. I felt quite anxious, quite on edge. I knew I wanted to sing. I knew I wanted to, you know, obviously start a solo career then, you know, that's what I had to do, so. But I hadn't got anything. There was no record deal, there was nothing confirmed.
Brendan,
nice to meet you.
Yeah,
nice to meet you.
And have a seat.
Yeah, cheers, man.
Yes.
I hear this is quite a famous studio, is it?
It's been around for a long time. This used to be Decca Records.
Yeah, I heard. Yeah. You. My dad's a big Patsy Cline fan.
Okay, yeah. She's just signed to Decca.
She's recorded here. Yeah, yeah. Okay. It feels like it needs it. Like it feels like a beat the whole way through. Like just straight from the beginning. Like
yeah.
Like a heartbeat. And, like the word, the heartbeat. See, all of a sudden now it's fucking. We're in Nashville. It's the first day of 2 weeks. Basically, I'm here to songwrite and find some great songs. I have a job to do, you know what I mean? I have a family to look after, so it's kind of, I have to make it happen. So I like the fact that I can write about that. And, you know, it's all about to kick off and I'm going to do it and kind of whatever it takes, you know? It was more to find a sound, I think, Nashville, because it was heading in that kind of folky, kind of up-tempo little vibe, you know, with a bit of country in there too. Just starting out in this solo journey, like, and you're in Nashville of all places, you know, and then we went to Graceland, you know, to see Elvis is the biggest solo artist ever.
I just feel like, I feel weird, like, I feel like I'm going to kind of, I feel like I'm going to meet somebody. Do you know what I mean? It's like, it's so famous, the house.
Come on in. Welcome to Graceland.
It's actually cooler than I expected. It's actually cooler. I thought, you know, you always kind of build yourself up, but, you know, you like you'd be let down. But I think since I came in, I've been like, wow. Like, this is a proper rock star, pop star's house, isn't it? Like, he had all his toys, all his tellies, his cinema, and his pool table, and, you know. He loved everything, like, just like any other fellow would, you know what I mean? Had his little bar, and his, like, his toys and stupid furniture that you buy in random countries for no reason, like. I've got thoughts stuff like that as well at home, like random stuff you pick up. It feels amazing, man. It just feels,
wow.
Feels like I've never felt like this before, you know what I mean? You feel like you're in a special place, obviously, you know, it's Elvis's house, but it's like, it's just, you kind of start picturing, man, they died there as well, you know? I never thought I'd see myself solo. I never thought I'd see myself walking through Elvis's kitchen. You know, stuff like that happens, and it's kind of like, you know what, it's happening for a reason. All this now is happening. It's just so amazing to listen to this. It's just like, it's just ridiculous how good it is. Like, these guys are just so gifted at playing music. Like, it's like a random party. It's like a random Sunday party, like, and they're all like these amazing musicians, you know? It's cool, it's so cool, man.
people I've been writing with, they're all here, you know, there's three or four of them here. This is a great finish, isn't it, to the whole thing. It's like, the whole trip, man, this is what the whole trip felt like to me. You know, the whole trip feels like it's this relaxed vibe. You come to Nashville and you're like, I have to get songs. No, you don't have to get anything. You come here to learn. You come here to hopefully get a song. But I know I have three or four, five possibly really good songs coming home. And it's like,
you gotta come over closer so you can hear it.
You know, it's like, you just feel like it's, you've been to something special.
I'm in heaven and it's going off tonight. And it's a wonderful life. Hey, I fill your glass with your favorite Merlot. Don't even ask. Just turn the lights down low.
Universal, we're on our way there now to London Records and to sign my long-term recording agreement. Probably the biggest day of my life for quite some time, maybe ever, I don't know.
The whole record deal thing was a very important thing because we had to make sure we got it right, you know, and we walked out of the first meeting and Louis said to me, that's who you're signing to. And I went, yeah? And he goes, no matter what anybody else offers us, no matter what other company, whatever, they're the people that will believe in you the most. Money is really, really like secondary in my life now. You know, it genuinely is. You know, you want to earn enough to live and all that, but it was about making the right decision with the right company.
Probably when I started writing songs, everything changed. Because then I started to see I'm writing these great songs because of what happened. You know, I've realised how lucky I am with such a, you know, a good family and my wife and kids and, like,
not like you realise how much they mean to you, because they already meant an awful lot to me, but it's like when all that stuff was gone, all that bad stuff was gone, you know, it kind of, it made me so determined. Like Louis always said to me, you know, when it all happened, I was like, oh my God, like I've lost everything. Like, you know, it felt like, and Louis's like, well, you haven't. He says, you haven't lost your voice.
If life was like a jigsaw, where would you start? You think you got the picture like it's written on your heart. You lay out all the pieces one by one. But if you stare at it too closely, the answer never comes. So I take a breath, take our time to figure this all out. I got lost inside what I thought I need, but I understand now.
I remember when we started writing it, I was thinking about Nicole, my daughter, and she's mad at her jigsaw, and I was kind of thinking, want to be mad if life was like a jigsaw? Where would you start? I kind of started from that. And then the kind of chorus goes, all I need is my family just to be happy. Going to LA was a big trip for me, obviously. It was my first video, my first photo shoot. And I kind of was the first week I kind of felt like, okay, I'm going solo here, you know, and there's all these crew out there. There was photographers, stylists, hairdressers, and everybody was there for Shane Filan for the first time in my life. This is it now. This is what I've been building up for the last year. So go out and nail it, you know.
It's my grease look.
What are you talking about, Zuko? You kidding me, Danny? Kaniki. Yeah, we got the car, remember?
So it's a big week for me, the following week. So I do all my kind of first radio interviews, and the song goes out there, so people will literally hear it. It'll be all over YouTube, my website and stuff like that. It's going to define where the rest of my life is going.
Big day today, to say the least.
Going to Kerry, to Ireland, for my first live TV performance, solo performance. So it's a pretty big day. It's like the biggest TV show in Ireland. It's like 1.3 million viewers or something, so it's pretty big for Ireland.
See you on the other side.
Rose of Tralee is like a beauty pageant, kind of, and it's been going on for years, like decades. It's just such a famous thing. It's like an institution in Ireland. Like, I remember being younger, having a bath, putting on my jammies, and we'd all sit and watch the Rose of Tralee. It was like one of those big things every year, you know, like the Eurovision.
I love your new song so much.
Thank you. What's your name?
Heather. Hi, how are you?
Good.
America.
How are you?
Very good.
Yeah, how are you? How are you? Oh, you're the lead from Rose. My mum says you were very good last night. Thank you. Thank you. Hey, which way am I going?
Follow me, Peter.
Where is she? Amy, how are you?
It's the biggest TV show in Ireland, obviously, all audience figures. Yeah, I'm chuffed to be asked. It's the first time I've ever performed solo on my own, so it's going to be definitely different, but I'm looking forward to it and excited about it. I love the song, so hopefully people will react to it in the crowd and stuff, and it's going to be good, hopefully.
Yeah, walking in, seeing one microphone stand. First time I've ever seen that. So it's mad, like little things like that. It's the first time I've seen things. You know, and just little things you just kind of go, okay, that's a bit different. But very excited though. You know what I mean? The whole thing is like, first shows in front of 2,000 people. You know, it's pretty cool. It could be a small little TV show with nobody there, so at least it'll have an atmosphere, and it'll definitely make things feel a bit, you know, more easier for my first show. Because it is, you know, it's a bit nerve-wracking, but I kind of don't feel like I'm flat out nervous either, though. I feel like I'm really excited about it all, do you know what I mean?
It's actually beginning. I'm you up.
It's still my first show, so it has to go well. Here we go, this is it.
No turning back!
Trumpets too.
It's fantastic.
plastic scene back up there on his own again.
The difference from when he came back from Nashville and he'd got the four or five really good songs, his confidence just soared after that, because he knew he could do it. And it was just, he needed that time to get that confidence to get started. But now you can just see it. He's oozing confidence up there. I used to ring and say, how'd you get on today? Oh, I wrote another song. And I'd say, all right, grand. And I wrote another song. It's just flowed out of it.
Here we go, lads. This is it, you know.
I'm sick.
Well,
I am.
Don't pass it over to me.
Yeah.
I'm feeling all right. I'm feeling kind of cool about it. Probably get the jitters just before you go on, but that's probably a good thing.
It's weird seeing him doing it on his own, yeah. Definitely. It's a bit lonely. Like, we used to see him, like, yeah, a lot of people, but he's not even a bit nervous, which is very unlike Shane. He's normally quite, you know, tense and stressed and, you know, but I'm more nervous than him. He's very relaxed.
Ladies and gentlemen, give a huge warm Kerry welcome to Shane Filan.
That performance was a huge relief. I was so happy, and obviously my friends and family and different people were texting me and going, well done, and the lads in the band and stuff like that were on to me and well done, saw the performance and stuff. And it was just that whole relief of going, okay, I can do this, you know, I can do this. The release of the EP then obviously came that weekend, the first single and then the other three songs on the EP, and a very nerve-wracking, you know, a couple of days leading up to that, because I just didn't know, you know, how it was going to do.
We're in Liverpool, first signing, so singles out, obviously 2 days now, so it's done really well. Great start, number one on iTunes and stuff like that, so it's all good. It is good to meet the fans, you know what I mean, because like a lot of the people coming here today will be proper fans, you know, that are like waiting for years to meet you and stuff like that. And like I did a couple of signings yesterday, we're in Glasgow and Newcastle. It was a great turnout, like you'd have 400 or 500 every signing, and like a really good turnout. It's always nice to have these people here, you know, support, because this is my first release, you know, this is my first week of officially being on iTunes or being out there for people to actually buy my music, you know, so it's a big week. And it's nice to see all the people coming down, you know. It's a lot of people, like, you know, they're waiting. Some of them are waiting, like, 13 hours yesterday. Which is just mad, you know. It's great.
Nothing else matters. You're everything to me. To me. You're everything to me.
It's beautiful. It's talented. It's caring. It's gorgeous. It's our everything. Idol. It's everything to me.
Thank you. Trying my best. With her. They come straight in for the hug. Oh, wait there, give me a second.
The first watch I've ever signed.
Him writing his own songs, like, it puts his touch on things as well. It's not just someone else's words, it's making it what he feels and stuff.
That's from all the fans on Twitter. Proud Filaners. That's getting a bit of a name now, the Filaners. Right, you're eating this. So this contract allows Caitlin McLean to illegally abduct Shane Filan and tie him underneath his her bed. Also, you have to have pictures with us. Oh, you got a tattoo?
Yeah.
Oh my God, geez, they're all getting tattoos. What's this about? So how many years have you been a fan of the band? Or?
Since you started.
Oh, thank you very
can
much.
Have a kiss.
Of course you can. Lovely to meet you.
Thank you.
Yes, I kissed him.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you.
Can you please make a font for us?
Oh no,
font,
please.
Take your bag, fill your cup. Put on your favorite song, turn it up. What a little piece of mind in the sunshine.
There you go. Take care.
You know, I can't thank the fans enough. You feel so humbled. Like, you feel like, oh my God, like, it's a nice feeling. I'm not going to lie. You know, when people come out to see you like that, you don't feel anything else but happiness. Bournemouth was again another very special day. You know, it's my first live kind of gig. Yeah, brought Gillian down first time. Obviously, my kids and all came to watch it, and there was 10,000 people, you know, on the beach and all up for it. You know, so how good of an atmosphere is that for your first gig? My kids are everything to me, but they are. They literally are. You know, and Gillian and the kids is. My whole world centres around them, but my kids are so important. Obviously, like every day I get up, I go to work, it's for my children. It's to look after their future and make sure they never have to worry like I worried or never had the problems I had. You know, and that's being honest. Every day I go singing, I think of them. Every day I get up, I think of them. You know, it's one of those things when you're a dad, it's the best job in the world. It's the best feeling in the world to be a dad. I'm so proud. I'm determined to do well because of my kids, you know, because I want them to kind of be proud of their daddy. I want them to kind of come to concerts and see me sing on stage. I suppose you wonder what it's going to be like to perform in front of an audience for the first time.
I'm feeling great. I'm feeling excited, a little bit nervous. First gig, about 10,000 people out there, so it's, you know, it seems to be a good crowd. So, but it's, I just feel good. I feel excited. Doing three really good songs. Everyone likes them so far, so hopefully they get a good reaction.
Best feeling in the world, you know. There's no better feeling being up on that stage, people looking at you and singing your songs, and you know, it's pretty amazing feeling. I definitely think you can hear a different sound in my voice on this album, but probably because the songs are very important to me. They're very honest and they're very truthful songs. There's a story to each song. All You Need to Know, I tried to tell the whole story in one song of how I was feeling in my life at that moment. And it was definitely probably the most honest, truthful lyric that came out. Everything you want, but I went back to Gillian and I said, I just wrote this song and I think it's really, really good. It's the first ballad. And I played it to her. She started crying. She started bawling. She got really upset. I will warm your heart like a winter sun. It's just the way it goes. You'll never be alone. It's all you need to know. It's obviously about Gillian and about my life, but it's kind of like a little conversation between the two of us. Because some of the lyrics are actually coming from stuff she said to me. There's lines in it, you've got desire, I understand, you keep on trying, you can reach my hand. That's her talking. She was there, like, with me through everything. Sometimes you gotta go deep to beat the tide. You got desire, I understand. If you keep on trying, you can reach my hand. Cause I'll be there, waiting on the other side. She loved me when I had nothing, she'd love me when I had everything, and she'd love me more when I had nothing again. Unbelievable respect for her, you know. I think that's maybe the best way to say it, but I just, you know, I kind of have her on this pedestal as this woman that looked after me when I really needed her. She really looked after me. It's all you need to know. You know, I can't ever repay her, obviously, or ever. All I can do is love her and look after her. So that's what this song is literally about. I give you everything I've got, and I will be a shoulder to cry on. What have I learned? Don't look too far ahead into the future. You know, or don't make any plans, because there's no point. I have a funny feeling, you know, I believe in fate. I believe in things happen for a reason. I have a funny feeling that my story is just being told. I don't know where the end of the story is, but I feel there's a story being told here. It's nearly hard to believe, but it's going somewhere, and it's going somewhere good at the moment. Whatever I get now, I'll take and be happy with that.
It's just the way it goes. It's just the way it goes. Whoa. It's all you need to know.